Hi, I'm Scotty. I service, repair and restore vintage and antique mechanical clocks. Welcome to Scotties Clock World. Well, we're ready to start preparing the parts to go into the ultrasonic. The first thing I do is bend a bit of wire out, join up pieces that go together so that we can tell easily what parts go on the, probably fit in there. It may come out, we'll see, tighten it up. What parts go on the going train? What parts go on the strike train? So I just use a little bit of wire to tighten them up, keep them together. There can be slight differences. Another one. That in there, and then that guy. There can be slight differences in similar parts in the clock, and if you put it the wrong part in the wrong place, it may not fit, it may be tight, it might throw something else out of whack. So this is an easy way to determine what goes where. We'll get the wheels in a moment. Wind them up. I've already put the nuts in a little tea strainer bag, which keeps them together so they don't drop into the bottom of the ultrasonic. Now we'll do the wheels. A couple there from the going side. Cut it up. Bend him over. And the escape wheel. Another one. Now I've got a few more pieces from the strike side, so we need a long bit of wire. Bend him in the middle. Whoop. First wheel, star wheel, the wheel, and the fly. That's got him. Tie them up. Right, they're all ready to go in to the ultrasonic. I'll bring the machine over and we'll put them in and we'll let it run. I'm currently warming up the solution in the ultrasonic, and now we can start putting the parts into the basket. Front and back plates. Going side train. Pop that over there, and the pallets. Another couple of wheels. And put the nuts in there also. And the motion works. That's the motion works. Right, I'll put the tray into the ultrasonic. Make sure that everything is submersed. turn it on, 23, 25 degrees. We want it to run for 5 minutes. So we'll turn it on and let it run. Once that's gone for the full time, we'll come back, we'll take the basket out, we'll clean the parts, wash them off with some lighter fluid, and then dry them with a hairdryer on low, and we'll bring them back in so we can reassemble the movement and start to look and see which bushes require rebushing if necessary. We've got the parts back from the ultrasonic. They look like they've cleaned up pretty well. I'll put them all out here on our bench. Then we'll start to reassemble the movement. Go over there. Over there. Our nuts. And put into our tray. We'll be using them pretty soon. Motion works. Strike side. Going train. All right, let's start to assemble the movement. One train at a time. And we'll see what rebushing we have to do. Scope wheel. Go there. All the nice clean parts. And the strike side. First wheel. Star wheel. Warning wheel. And the fly. This is the rack hook right here. That pin, when you put the gathering pallet back on before you hammer it down to keep it firm, that pin has to fall.